Hey guys, so today I'm going to be doing a get ready with me. I'm going to be doing my makeup and hair, and I'll be getting ready for my graduation picture. So yeah, let's just go ahead and get started. So the first thing I'm going to do is just put my hair up into a ponytail. Try to get all of my flyaways. I don't even know what these pieces are doing. Then I'm just getting this headband that is dirty. Has all kinds of makeup on it. Need to wash it. But then just taking that, covering it up so I don't get a lot of makeup in my hair. After that, I'm getting the Clinique Moisture Surge Extended Thirst Relief Gel Cream. Pretty much it's moisturizer. And I'm just going to apply that all to my face. It doesn't take much. It spreads easily. If, like, I keep looking over here, it's because it's my mirror, and I can't really see behind my camera because I'm using my phone. So what I see is my mirror that I put behind my phone to make sure it's still videoing, kind of like my own viewfinder. But this is why I don't do self-tanner myself. Next thing I'm getting is the Bare Minerals Primetime Primer, and it's the original one, and I'm just getting like a pump of that and applying that all over my face. A little goes a long way. This is like the only primer that I like. I went to the store and bought one, like a drugstore one. It was the Milani brand for $10. My makeup stayed on good, but I have really sensitive skin, and it has to have like oil free, and I don't know. So the next thing I'm getting is this Becca Shimmering Skin Perfector, and this is opal. Yeah. So I'm just applying this all over my face. The reason I'm doing this is to give my skin a glow, because I do want a full coverage but a glowy look. So I'll be using a medium to full coverage foundation, but this will give it a shine to make it look like more natural and more glowy. Alright, so the next thing I'm doing is getting into the foundation. I'm using the Milani foundation. Because I've used a spray tan and I'm turning light again, but I'm still kind of dark, I'm going to mix the light beige, which is number 3, and the 00, which is light natural. And I'm just going to mix those two together. And I like this foundation a lot. I've been using it for almost a year. And it's like my go-to. Like, I don't really use much other ones. I tried the Wet n Wild one, and that one was great, but it broke me out, and I think it did, because every time I use it, like a week later, I start getting pimples. So like I said, I have sensitive skin, so some things just don't work for me, which is okay, because I love the Milani one and it's cheap. But what I'm doing is just mixing that with my finger. My hands are clean, by the way. And then I'm just putting that on my face. I'm getting my beauty blender. I didn't damp it or anything. I know a lot of people that do, but most of the time I don't, just because I like how it looks without any water in the beauty blender. And I'm just making sure I blend that nicely. Lately I've been having like really bad breakouts on my chin, and I have no clue why. But it's just, I don't know. I used to play soccer, and whenever I did, my forehead would break out really bad during the season. So, don't really know what that has to do with it either. What I'm gonna do is just, that sounded funny. What I'm just doing is going down my neck and blending the self-tanner, because it does look crazy. Okay, so after I do that, I'm getting the Butter Bronzer by Physicians Formula, and just getting a contour bronzer brush and just applying that on my face. They always say to do like a 3, so try to get your forehead, your cheekbone, and then your jaw. This is for my people back home. Mix it strong, pour it out, no doubt. We're always thinking about you. Okay, so after I do that, I'm getting the ColourPop concealer, the No Filter concealer. This is the shade Fair 08. This is very light, but I kind of like it because it brightens up my face whenever I'm using it. I wish it was a little darker, but like I said, it's okay. I'm just using this under my eyes, down my nose, on my chin where I have the problem areas, and then on my forehead in the middle. And then again, I'm just getting the beauty blender and I'm just going to blend it in with everything else. Y'all know who you are, baby. You're in every song I sing. You're in every dream I dream. You're the beat inside of me. Y'all be inside of me. This is for my people back home. We light and water, feel the love. We wouldn't be here without you. This is for my people back home. Mix it strong, pour it. But the next thing out that I'm getting is the Real Her Be Fearless Be Limitless blush kit, and it has like a pinky color, like a pinky purple, a coral, and then like a bronzy brown pinky color. I don't really know how to explain it, but I'm just going to get this blush brush and go in with the coral and the brown color and just apply that. You don't want to do it like a smile. You don't want to do it right on your cheeks. You want to kind of go up with it to go like with your bronzer, so then it'll go with the highlight. So what I'm going to do is just do this and then smile and just blend it like that. And the next thing that I'm going to do are my eyebrows. So what I do is just brush them out before I color them in with anything. I already have thick eyebrows, so I don't do much with them. But I do put some color into them, especially if I'm going all out with my makeup. What I'm doing is just getting a small angled brush. And then I'm getting the ColourPop. It's like a gel brow. Product. It's the gel brow, and this is the shade Bang & Brunette. Another picture, another stage, but I hope you know I miss you, and a part of me still with you, and no matter where I go or what I do, I won't forget. Okay, so after I do my eyebrows, I'm going to get eyeshadow primer, and I have the Photo Focus Wet n Wild eyeshadow primer. This works amazing. I think I've been using this for almost a year, 2 years. It applies on smoothly and my eyeshadow stays on amazing. So once you just blend that in real well, what I'm going to do is get this Airspun loose face powder. It's like a translucent powder. I'm gonna use this flat brush to just get that face powder and shape how I want my eyeshadow. Okay. So what I'm going in with is the Jaclyn Hill palette. I got this not too long ago. I love it so much. So I'm getting this shade right here, and it's called MFEO, and I'm just gonna apply that in my crease. I gotta find the brushes. Okay. So I found the brush. So again, I'm just going with that shade MFEO. And there is a hair on my brush. I'm just going in the crease and just trying to blend that everywhere. In that town that we grew up in, if it wasn't for all y'all, this old boy would be nothing. You're running through our hearts, you've been here from the start. Yeah, you know who. Okay, so after I get done using that, I'm going to get... Sorry, there is an eyelash. No, a hair, not an eyelash. A huge hair on my eye. I'm going to get the shade Hooter. This third shade. And I'm just going to use that on my V and crease. Okay, after I do that, I'm gonna get this shade down here, Mocha, and I'm just gonna, which is a darker shade, and I'm just gonna do the same thing, and with the blending brush, just put that a little more on the lid, outer lid, and in the crease. The next thing that I'm gonna do for my lid, I'm going to get the L'Oreal True Match highlighter. And I'm just gonna put a little bit of this on my hand. And I'm getting a brush like this. It's a skinny round brush. And I'm just gonna put this on my lid. Okay, so after I put that on my lid, what I'm gonna do is take this pink shade right here, and it's called Faint, and just with my finger, gently pat it on the spot that I just put the highlighter on. After that, what I'm gonna do is take the ColourPop blending brush, go back, and in the shade Mocha, the darkest shade, I'm going to just get that, go back over the crease and the V. And then I'm just gonna get the ColourPop brush and just blend all of that. Get the shade in the Jaclyn Hill palette in light and just put that on my brow bone. Then I'm just going to put that on my inner corner. After that, I'm just getting a fluffy brush and I'm just gonna translucent powder away. Get the Almay eyeliner. Okay, the next thing that I'm gonna do is get the Tarte mascara primer and just apply that on my eyelashes. Then I'm going to get Tardiest mascara in the Lash Sensational and just do my eyelashes real quick, and then I'll be back. Okay, so I did my eyelashes and this is what the eyes look like. The next thing that we're gonna do is apply highlighter. So I'm getting this Revolution Champagne color highlight. And I'm just gonna do dots at my face and pat that with my finger and rub it, gently rub it. Then I'm getting the Becca highlighter in the shade Opal, and I'm just getting a highlighting brush and applying that on top of the cheekbones. And last but not least, I'm getting the shade Echo Park by ColourPop. This is the satin lip. And I'm just putting this on my lips. Oh, this is actually the last but not least. Last but not least, I'm just getting the Urban Decay All Nighter setting spray. And just spraying that on my face. Okay, so now I'm gonna do my hair, and I'm just going to section it off into different sections so I can work on it. Alright, so I'm just gonna brush the bottom part out and make sure you use heat protectant. And then let that sit and dry for a second. Then get hairspray. I'm using the Big Sexy Hair. And the heat protectant that I just used, it's leave-in conditioner. I just ran out of heat protectant. And I'm getting the hot tools, and I'm just gonna wrap it outwards. In the way that I was raised, and now my life's another city, another picture, another stage. But I hope you know I'm now. I'm just letting that section down and doing another section of hair. It's not gonna stay. Then I am taking the last section down. If it'll come out. Well, guys, oh my gosh. Okay, there we go. It's all good. I'm parting my hair the way I want the curls to go. My people back home. Okay, so after I curl my hair, I'm just gonna kind of brush through it. After that, I'm just gonna flip my hair, shake it. After that, I'm just spray it. And voila! Okay, so this is the final look. I got my dress and shoes on, my hair done, my makeup done, and yeah, so. No doubt.